Yo, what's going on, Planet S.O.N family? It's your main man, JD. Thank you for tuning in. This is Drinks with JD. All right, my main man, Young G.
What's going on? How you doing?
I'm good, man. Thank you. Thank you so much for being here on Drinks with JD.
Oh, yeah, man.
I appreciate you. Thank you for making the drive.
I appreciate you having me. We're supposed to link up. We're supposed to make it happen. So, yeah, I appreciate it.
Yeah, no, man. Thank you so much. I appreciate you being here.
Yeah, I dig your show. It's dope. So,
No doubt.
It's an honor to be on it.
Thank you. Thank you so much, my brother. All right, man. So, let's introduce you to the Planet S.O.N audience.
Mm-hmm.
Can you please let me know who you are,
mm-hmm.
where you're from, and what you do?
Well, my name is Young G. I'm a musician, a father, a mentor, football coach, and all the above.
All right, no doubt.
I'm from San Diego, California, and I'm all of the above.
No doubt.
I grew up here a long time. So,
No doubt. Okay, that's what I'm talking about, bro. All right, man, so let's take it back a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so I know you just mentioned that you're from San Diego.
Mm-hmm.
However, where were you born and raised?
So, early in my days, I grew up in, like, North Park.
Okay.
Yeah, East Dago, California. And then I ended up moving around to like Lemon Grove, then back over by Federal in the southeast.
Mm-hmm.
And then I lived by Keeler at one point.
Okay.
And then Spring Valley. So I've been in Spring Valley the most bit of my time.
No doubt.
So from high school on, about in the end of my middle school and high school, that's where I've been. I kept my family there when we were living out here. So yeah.
That's what I'm talking about.
Yeah. So
and where were you born?
So my original state where I was born was I was born in Seattle, Washington.
Wow, okay.
Yeah, I moved down here when I was around one or two. I don't remember.
Okay.
I gotta ask my mom. Don't quote me on it. But
No doubt. Yeah. No, it's similar to me because I was born in Los Angeles.
Okay.
But my father moved us to San Diego when I was 4 years old.
Got you. Okay.
So I completely understand.
You've been here for the most part of your life.
Yeah, so. I mean, we're San Diegans.
Yeah.
So it is what it is.
Definitely. Yeah. Anytime I'm out of town, I'm repping SD.
No doubt. Yeah. Likewise.
Yeah.
All right, my brother. So, matter of fact, I guess we'll stay on that topic.
Mm-hmm.
What brought your family from Washington State to San Diego?
So, my dad is from KC.
Okay.
My mom is from Seattle.
Mm-hmm.
She had a best friend up there, and then her husband at the time, that was my dad's best friend.
Okay.
So then they connected them, and you know,
went from there.
You know, we lived up there for a little bit, and then we moved out here.
Okay. So why San Diego? Why were your parents like, you know what, I want to go to Southern Cali?
You know why? I think for the most part, we already had family members that were here that kind of already migrated here from KC,
okay,
Tennessee. So it was like, okay, let's go ahead and move down there. And then they lived right in, hard in San Diego, Salola.
No doubt.
Southeast, right there by Lincoln.
No doubt. Okay. Yeah. And do you ever travel back to, like, let's say, Washington State or Missouri?
Mm-hmm.
Or is it on the Kansas side?
So it's both.
Okay.
It's both, Wichita.
Yeah.
Topeka. It's all over Bonner Springs. So okay. it's all over.
Okay.
So they all spread over everywhere. But yeah, here and there we go back. We do family reunions sometimes in Tennessee.
Yeah.
Oh, so wow. Yeah. So yeah.
That's where my grandma's originally from,
and then they ended up moving to Seattle. So yeah, we everywhere, man.
Okay.
Yeah, we originally come from the South, so then everybody kind of migrates wherever they go.
That's cool. All right, that's what I'm talking about. All right. So I know that you also mentioned where you grew up within the city, like mm-hmm. North Park and also Spring Valley and
mm-hmm.
stuff. So just so I guess we could get to know you better and also relate to you more than what we know about you.
Mm-hmm.
Can you please let us know where you went to school?
All the way from when I was a kid?
Yeah. What school did you go to?
Oh, man. I can't even remember.
Okay.
So, yeah, my parents had me, they had me bouncing around. But I'm going to give you the middle school and up, because I think that's whenever, I went to Palm Middle School.
Okay.
Now it's some other academy or whatever it's called now. But okay. I went to Palm Middle School, and then I went to Monta Vista High School.
So that's
why I was always over there. In elementary, I was everywhere. So it's like I was at Erickson.
Yeah.
I was at... what's the school right there, right by S. Penn? I went to Penn Elementary.
Okay.
I went everywhere. I went to Garfield.
Yeah.
Yeah, I went everywhere, man.
No doubt.
Yeah, I was moving around.
Okay. Now, you know how, what we know and how you introduce yourself, you're a music artist, right?
Mm-hmm.
So when you were a kid, were you interested in different things other than music?
Yeah, football.
Okay.
For sure, I play sports.
No doubt.
I still love football more than I love music.
Yeah.
If I can get back out there and play right now, I would, but Yeah, football was my thing. I went to college playing it.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, yeah, the scholarship and went Division I. So, wow. Yeah, I love football.
That's amazing. Can you talk a little bit about that? What school did you go to?
So I went to Weber. I went to Monta Vista, but then right there I got a full ride scholarship. I went to go to Weber State.
Wow.
Then I came. I had bounced back. Came with the Mason. I went up to Washington State. So
wow.
Yeah, it was good. You know,
that's amazing, man.
You gotta still make sure you get your smarts and have your brains right.
Of course.
You know, so you know, at the same time I was still doing music through it all. But
that's what I'm talking about.
And then a couple of things just switched up. Coaches switched. Injuries, things like that.
Yes,
so then
yes,
I had
yes.
my son too. So I had my son at 8 when I. Like when I was 8, I just turned 18. I had my son. So
okay.
It was a lot I was dealing with, trying to be a dad and, you know, be a student athlete and stuff like that. So,
of course.
Yeah, it was tough.
Okay, what position did you play?
Running back.
Wow.
Yeah, I played running back and linebacker in high school, but when I went to college, I played running back.
That's what I'm talking about, man. Okay.
Yeah.
What did you study in college?
So when you all go to college, you know, as a football player, it's just like, oh, yeah, put him in the easiest classes. So mm-hmm. versus general, and then you get into communication. So mm-hmm. that's what I did. But okay. I still want to go back and get a bachelor's of science. So
oh,
that's
wow.
one thing I okay. do want to do still, just to do. I got like 24 more credits to do anyway to finish that. So
no doubt.
Yeah, man. I want to get 2 of them. So that's what I really want to do.
That's what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
Okay, so, but why communication?
I think at the time, you know, when it's one of the easiest things, and to be honest with you, when, as a football player, it's mm-hmm. kind of like in college, there's no... I know they say education and everything, but it's when you're there on a scholarship, mm-hmm. it's football.
Yeah,
you know, so
that's right.
what you're there for.
That's right.
So you know, when you go in there, that's probably the easiest things to kind of get through with mm-hmm. with the courses and the classes and the units. So, you know, that was at first, but then I knew you can kind of do that. You can use that for everything. And it also helped me write. It also helped me communicate. It also helped me with my me being on the artist side too. Mm-hmm. So it was good. I mean, you know, it wasn't really like something I really wanted to do, but I really didn't know what I wanted to do. I'm gonna be honest. I just wanted to play football. So that was my dream. So
that's what I'm talking about, man. Okay. Now, you know how you mentioned how, well, first of all, you're a music artist now, right?
Mm-hmm.
But even in college, you were also doing your music while playing football and also studying, right?
Yeah.
So when were you interested in music? Like, when did you start your interest?
I was a kid.
Okay.
I used to be like 2 years old. You know the song? Okay. Poison, I'd be dead asleep, my mom telling me, man. And I wake up, dead drool out my mouth, everything.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
That girl is poison. You know,
no
so
doubt,
I already
no
knew.
Doubt.
So then I'd always like to sing. I was in the choir.
Wow, really?
Yeah, yeah.
That's what I'm talking
and
about.
Then my dad had a label back in the day. He was messing with Mitchie and J.O. A lot of these guys, Sugar Free. We was all, you know, a lot of these guys, Sykes City, a lot of these guys from San Diego.
Oh,
and then, so we used to see it, and, you know, me and my brothers and them, and we used to want to do it. So it was like, oh, yeah, we started doing stuff, making beats on their equipment and stuff in the studio. So it was just get down, and it was terrible, but we would do it. And people in our school would like it, like, our, you know, people in middle school. Like I said, we've been doing this since elementary.
No doubt.
People in the schools would be bumping us. And so, yeah, it's kind of like now how the kids do it now, how the kids in the high school are really their true fans. And they pushed him to the next level.
That's what I'm talking about. Okay. Now, did you start off with poetry, or was it just bars? Like, you know what? I'm 7 years old with bars.
I wanted to be the first kid gangster rapper.
Okay.
That's what I wanted to do.
Yeah.
I loved Ice Cube. Yeah. You know, I loved Snoop. I loved.
So from the beginning.
From the beginning, I loved it all. You know, Too Short, E-40. Yeah. I mean, I loved it all. I wanted to be like Sebo.
Yeah.
Looney Coley. I mean, I wanted to be a. A kid gangster rapper when I was a kid. Yeah, so that's really where I, then it kind of evolved into what I'm doing now. So
Now I know that you know, well, obviously how you were talking about how you started when you were young, right?
Mm-hmm.
So obviously there was a point when your family knew that, hey, you know what, you know, young G is actually trying to pursue this. Now were your family members and your friends, were they encouraging, like, hey man, keep pursuing your dream?
So, I mean, yeah, there was nothing negative. It was nothing never, like, negative about it. But it wasn't something that was truly on my mind. Like, I did it because I was good at it and I liked it as a hobby at the time. But I was stuck on playing football. So, for me, most of my things was, you know, working out, outside, playing sideline pops, like I mentioned in the song. You know, just things like that. So,
Okay.
So, yeah, it wasn't like that until it was around... like 2010 maybe was when I really kind of started getting going. That's when Wiz Khalifa started coming on the scene, and I was traveling around and doing shows. And So yeah, that's when they kind of knew. And then in 2012, I worked with E40. So then everybody was like, okay, yeah.
Okay, that's what I'm talking about. Okay.
So, yeah.
Now, I know that right now you mentioned how your father, he owned a record label, right? Mm-hmm. So, well, from your father, right, being in music, and also for his son, which is, you know, yourself, mm-hmm. Having the music gene, mm-hmm. you know, within you. Mm-hmm. Did you ever connect, let's say, with your family, or did anybody else in your family have that same dream where, like, you guys wanted to do it together and just connect and just build within music?